We begin this afternoon's business, and I welcome representatives of the ALLIPA Party who join us here today. The sudden passing of the Right Honourable Alex Salmond on the 12th of October has shocked and saddened us all, and we gather this afternoon to express our condolences as a Parliament. Alex Salmond's contribution to the development and life of this Parliament is an integral part of our history. Elected to the Parliament in 1999, one of the first members of this Parliament, Alex was leader of the largest opposition party in our formative days. He was elected to the Parliament again in 2007 and elected as our fourth First Minister, serving from 2007 to 2014, holding office throughout Session 3 and much of Session 4. He will be remembered for forming the first SNP government and for winning a remarkable overall majority in 2011. I have received messages of tribute from parliaments and governments worldwide, along with some personal reflections of meetings with Alec. All who have written remark on his immense impact on political life in Scotland. One says, "The invaluable contribution of Alex Salmond to Scotland and his tireless dedication to public service are legacies that will not be forgotten. His commitment to the interests of the Scottish people and his vision for a strong and vibrant independent Scotland forged an indelible mark on the history of the nation." All of the tributes that I have received express sincere condolences to those who feel the loss of Alex Salmond most keenly on a personal level. It can be too easy to forget that such a well-known public figure was a husband, brother, uncle and friend to many. And we hope that the countless tributes from far and wide provide some measure of comfort to Alex's loved ones. Our thoughts are with you. I call on the First Minister to speak and to move the motion of condolence.
Presiding Officer, it is with sadness that I move this motion of condolence on the death of Alex Salmond, the fourth First Minister of Scotland. On behalf of the Scottish Government and the people of Scotland, I express my deepest sympathies to Alex's wife Moira and to his family and to his friends. There have been many tributes made since Alex's sudden death. They include tributes left outside of this building and many signatures added to the book of condolence here in the Scottish Parliament and online. The flags on Scottish Government buildings flew at half-mast at the time of his death. They did so again yesterday on the occasion of his funeral, and they will do so again today as this motion of condolence is debated. And of course, we witnessed the minute of applause at Scotland's recent football match with Portugal, a tribute to Alex's enduring love of the beautiful game. Alex Salmond left an indelible mark on Scotland and on Scottish and United Kingdom politics and public life. He was born in Linlithgow in 1954, and it wasn't long before his reputation for being a rebel was built. He studied economics at the University of St Andrews and joined the Scottish National Party during that time, becoming an influential member of the 79 group. Elected politics for Alex Salmond began in 1987, when he became the MP for Bamford Buchan, one of only three SNP MPs at that time. He went on to serve in the same constituency when this Parliament was first elected in 1999. In a political career that spanned three decades and two parliaments, Alex became leader of the Scottish National Party in 1990 and then again in 2004. He became the first SNP First Minister of Scotland in 2007, serving in that role for over 7 years. He led a government wholly devoted to serving the people of Scotland. That government and that devotion to Scotland and her people continues today. I first met Alex in the SNP club in North St Andrews Street in Edinburgh in 1981. He'd come to speak to literally a handful of young Scottish nationalists, of which I was one, who were trying to stir things up in Edinburgh for our cause. Much of what I heard from Alec that day, 43 years ago, is reflected in the assessments we have heard in recent days of Alex's contribution to Scottish politics. He was creative in the arguments he put forward. He was driven to make the case for Scottish independence. He was fierce in his analysis of political rivals and determined to challenge their positions. He was, in short, a man o' independent mind, a reference taken from his favourite Burns poem, which summed up his politics and his aspirations. I served for 7 years as his finance and economy secretary. It was a relationship generally defined by the First Minister wanting to spend more money than we actually had available, and the finance secretary trying to make as many of the First Minister's creative ideas happen as was possible. It was never a relationship without challenging moments, but he did recognise, perhaps reluctantly, that possessing financial credibility was always an advantage in government. Many of the significant moments in my political life took place when I was working closely with Alex Salmond. Our success in securing the re-election of Winnie Ewing to the European Parliament in 1994, when she was joined by our dear friend Dr. Alan McCartney. Rosanna Cunningham's success in the Perth and Kinross by-election in 1995, my own election to the House of Commons in 1997, persuading our party to support a yes, yes position in the 1997 referendum. The election at that time of the largest group of SNP parliamentarians in one night in the 1999 elections to the Scottish Parliament. Our entry into government in 2007, the passing of the first budget of an SNP government in 2008, and the build-up to the independence referendum in 2014. These were all landmark moments that brought much joy, but I have to acknowledge that our relationship changed over the last 6 years. We all know in life that human relationships can change. One moment they are strong, the next they are not. And politics is no different, because politics at all levels is simply about people. What cannot be denied by anyone is that Alex Salmond led the Scottish National Party from the fringes of Scottish politics to become the Government of Scotland and to come so close to winning our country's independence. That has changed Scotland and her politics forever. It is now up to those of us who believe that Scotland should be an independent country to make that case and to win that future.
I now call on Russell Findlay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The sudden passing of Alex Salmond at the age of 69 reminds us all how precious but precarious life is. In the words of our national bard, who Alex Salmond often quoted, "Nae man can tether time or tide." Just a few weeks ago, he was here in the Scottish Parliament to mark the 25th anniversary along with His Majesty the King. And in the hours before his death, Alex Salmond was still hard at work, engaged in political activism. However anybody feels about his politics, we can surely all recognise his duty and commitment to public service. Alex Salmond served his constituents for decades as an MSP, an MP and as First Minister for Scotland. And it's in that spirit that I pay tribute to him today, because I must confess I didn't know him and I never met him. I'm unable to provide a personal tribute to Alex Salmond as others in this chamber can. I wasn't close to him as the First Minister was, having served as his Finance Secretary for many years. I didn't work with him as those in the SNP benches did for decades, or as Ash Reagan has done in recent years. I didn't know Alex Salmond the man, but everyone in Scotland knew Alex Salmond the politician. He was a figure whose presence loomed large across my life and our country. Nationalist or unionist, there was no ignoring him. As a former journalist, I appreciated his flair for understanding how to grab attention and to make headlines. He was a powerful and commanding presence in this chamber and in the House of Commons. A formidable politician of undoubted talent who could both inspire and intimidate. I know that many across this chamber, whether on our benches or on others, would be wary about the prospect of going up against him. And beyond the corridors of Holyrood and Westminster, his influence shaped our society. He made a lasting impact on our country. And how many politicians can that be said about? It has been noted that Alex Salmond was a complicated and at times controversial figure who divided opinion, often strongly. And today's not the occasion for a verdict on his every action. However, we can say with confidence there will be a place for him in the history books. He created modern Scottish nationalism. He personified the independence movement of his age, and those facts cannot be denied. And from a unionist perspective, as someone who values Scotland's proud place in the United Kingdom, I will still pay tribute to a man who held the office of First Minister for so many years. And from the outside, it seemed to me that Alex Salmond took the role of First Minister deadly seriously. As a journalist and as a member of the public, it appeared to me that he acted with great energy and sincerity. And again, while profoundly disagreeing with his vision for Scotland, I have no doubt that he was utterly sincere in his beliefs. So I pay tribute to the service of Alex Salmond. I offer my party's sincere condolences to his family, especially to his wife, Moira. And our thoughts are also with his friends and his colleagues. May he rest in peace. Nae man can tether neither time or tide. Thank you.
Thank you. I now call on Anna Sarwar.
The sudden death of Alex Salmond came as a shock for me and for millions of people across our country. And my thoughts and those of everyone at Scottish Labour are with his wife Moira, his friends, family and colleagues in both the parties he led. And as we saw yesterday at his poignant send-off in his beloved Strachan, the loss of Alex Salmond has been felt keenly by people in his own local area, as well as across the political spectrum and across our society. Alec was committed to his constituents and to the people that he served in both Holyrood and Westminster for over three decades. He was a politician of rare and unique political ability, whose impact and legacy on Scottish politics cannot be overstated. And as it will be for others in this chamber or for many listening at home, Alex Salmond was a big figure in Scottish politics throughout my adult life. So it will be hard to imagine the world of Scottish politics without Alex Salmond on our screens, on our airwaves, on doorsteps or even on podiums. And as we mentioned before, he joined the SNP on the fringes of our political life, and through his leadership, he transformed the party and brought it into the mainstream of our politics. From the 1980s to the present day, Alex Salmond was a mainstay of Scottish and UK politics. In Westminster and Holyrood, Alec dominated the political scene and excelled as a parliamentarian of clear skill and with a gift for a turn of phrase. And as SNP First Minister, Alec wrote his name into the history books and secured his place in our national story. Now, many people may not know this, but Alex Salmond was also a parliamentary colleague of my father at Westminster. They both served as MPs at the same time, and I'm not sure how members on the SNP benches will feel about this, but I recall Alec on several occasions trying to convince my father that I should ditch the Labour Party and join the SNP instead. Now, he didn't succeed in that, but I think it demonstrates Alec's bold confidence that allowed him to confound the odds time and time again. For many of us, Scottish politics will never be the same without him. First and foremost, Alec was a committed Scottish nationalist. As a leader of the Yes campaign, he led it with skill, energy and enthusiasm. And it will come as no surprise that I and Alex Salmond had very different views on the future of our country. But as the person that led the Labour campaign to remain in the UK, I came across Alex Salmond on many occasions throughout that referendum. But on every occasion, he remained polite and civil, despite the temperature of that debate. Never far from controversy, Alec never shied away from making his views known with that, as I said, characteristic confidence. Alex was always made passionate arguments and he knew how to get his points across. And let's not pretend that he wasn't also of the ability or ever afraid to clamp a political opponent or a journalist if he had the opportunity. But through it all, he kept his natural charm and his affability. Scotland is a very different place due to the political career of Alex Salmond. A controversial, but also a charismatic figure. And his absence will be felt by many. He leaves behind two parties that he was fundamental in the existence of, and a generation of politicians who looked to him in those movements as a father figure and as a mentor. This will be a particularly difficult time for many of Alex's former colleagues, his friends and family, and in particular his wife, Moira. He was a huge part of their life, and I know so many will be feeling his loss deeply. On behalf of Scottish Labour, I send my sincere condolences to all who mourn the loss of Alex Salmond in this chamber and across our country.
I now call on Patrick Harvey.
Everything that we do here, we do despite our differences. The whole purpose of a parliament is to bring people together, regardless of what separates us in political, professional or personal terms. And that's never more true than at a moment like this, when we're recognising the loss of someone who made a profound impact over many years. Every politician, especially those who serve in the highest office, understand the impact on personal and family life. And this aspect of the role is a sacrifice for the individual, but it is also a sacrifice for their family and friends as well. So it's important that Parliament as a whole recognises the loss that Alex Salmond's family and friends are experiencing now and offer our sincerest condolences. And especially in the wake of such an unexpected death, it's a moment to begin to acknowledge the impact of the life that has ended. People's lives and their legacies can be contested and they can be complicated. So this is not a moment for an assessment of the entirety of the man. There will be more appropriate times for that. But on the scale of Alex Salmond's impact on Scotland's politics, that's something we can all acknowledge. The events of the last few years are an important part of his story, but they do not change the fact that Alex Salmond was the political personality who enabled the SNP to advance in its political journey. When this parliament first met 25 years ago, the SNP had just a handful of well-known faces and names in national politics. Suddenly, they were the main opposition party. And within 8 years, they were not only ready to form a government, they were chosen to do so by the Scottish people. When they did so, Alex Salmond called it what it was. This might seem simple to say now, but he recognised that the office of First Minister is the highest office in Scottish politics, and that the group of people who sit on the front bench of this Parliament to be held accountable by the representatives of Scotland are not merely an administration, but a government. In showing his understanding of that, in giving the right name to this young political landscape, Alex Salmond advanced Scotland's political journey. In the early years of this Parliament, the idea of independence was by no means in its infancy. A large minority had consistently supported it. But the case for independence as a viable proposition had barely been developed. Some people will remember Alex Salmond for the phrase, "The dream will never die." But in his time at the forefront of Scottish politics, he did more than most to turn it from a dream into a tangible, imminent choice, something that even its strongest opponents had to recognise as a real choice which Scotland could make work. That legacy endures, and independence remains an undeniably real and imminent choice, there for the taking, if the people will it.
I now call on Alex Cole-Hamilton.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, today we commemorate the sudden death of Alex Salmond, the passing of a political pioneer of our age. Whether we agreed with him or not, he challenged us to picture things differently, to picture Scotland and its place in the world differently. Alex Salmond was an unapologetic disruptor and a formidable opponent for any parliamentarian or interviewer. While we never sat in this chamber at the same time, I have faced him in debate, and I know the work that my predecessors had to do, the preparation that was required to try and get the better of him. Such was his strength in any arena. He joined forces with the likes of Jim Wallace and Donald Dewar in the effort to deliver our Scottish Parliament before going on to do something few thought possible, obtaining an overall majority in a Parliament designed for minorities. a result that sparked the two-year-long referendum campaign and intense public discourse about Scotland's place in the United Kingdom, a discussion that continues to this day. It was perhaps the most significant moment in the life of this 25-year-old Parliament, and his role, his influence, and his personality were all at the centre of that. In so many ways, today's SNP government is one in his image, even a full decade after his departure from it. There will be time to debate Alex Salmond's legacy and the impact he had, both political and personal, but today we recognise the substantial impact that he had on our politics, and on behalf of the Scottish Liberal Democrats, I wish comfort to all those who mourn him today, especially his wife Moira and his close friends and family.
I now call on Ash Regan.
We gather today not only to mourn the loss of a political giant, but to celebrate the life and legacy of Alex Salmond, Scotland's most extraordinary First Minister. Alex was not just a leader, he was a unifying force, awakening the political consciousness of a nation and inspiring us to dream bigger for ourselves and for Scotland. To Alex's beloved wife, Moira, his family, Margaret, Gail, Bob, and all who knew him closely, the thoughts and sincere condolences of all in the ALBA party are with you. I hope the tributes pouring in from across Scotland and beyond offer some comfort during this difficult time. And we stand beside you in your grief, just as Alex stood beside Scotland in every battle, every challenge, and every triumph. Alex did not just help shape this institution, he forged its very identity. Under his leadership, the Scottish Parliament transformed from an assembly into a parliament. His energy, passion, and political will were unparalleled, and he loved this country with a pride that radiated from his very being. Even his critics could not deny the force of his conviction. And when, against all the odds, he led the SNP to a historic majority in 2011, it was not just a victory for a party. It was a mandate for an idea that the people of Scotland should decide our nation's future. The 2014 independence referendum, spearheaded by Alex, saw 84% of Scots turn out to have their voices heard. And while the result was not what many of us might have hoped for, the campaign itself ignited a democratic fire that has not been extinguished. Alex Salmond's political life was dedicated to a profound cause, the belief in Scotland's right to choose our own path. And through that tireless effort, he took the Scottish National Party from the fringes of politics to the pinnacle of government, making it the dominant force in Scotland. His vision gave this nation the confidence that it had long been denied, and his accomplishments in office speak for themselves, including abolishing bridge tolls and prescription charges, eliminating university tuition fees, hosting the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, and harnessing Scotland's green energy potential to position Scotland to take full advantage of the renewable revolution, and, of course, the record-breaking Queen's Ferry crossing. Ambition in devolved politics was a statement of competence and confidence in what Scotland could achieve through fairness, compassion, and independence. Alex Salmond was a man of intellect and strategy, but above all, he was a man of the people, and he had that rare ability to make complex issues accessible to everyone. And he took the time to listen to and speak to people all across Scotland, Whether he was addressing a crowded village hall or standing before world leaders, he represented Scotland with pride, with dignity, and a wit that often disarmed even his staunchest opponents. His presence on the world stage brought our cause to the attention of leaders across Europe and beyond, and his articulate vision of a fairer, more prosperous Scotland inspired generations. Alex showed us that the path to a better Scotland begins with self-belief, and he spread that message far and wide, ensuring that the seeds of ambition were sown in every corner of the land, that Scotland could stand tall, shoulder to shoulder with other nations, proud and independent. And his resilience and confidence wasn't just admirable, it was also contagious, a source of inspiration that ignited a fire that encouraged us to aim higher and to believe in better. He could dismantle an argument with a single quip or rally a movement with a stirring call to arms, his oratory skills leaving both colleagues and adversaries in his shadow. His voice, wisdom, and unwavering commitment to justice reassured us all, even in the most challenging of times. And he leaves behind a forever changed Scotland, more confident, more assertive, and above all, determined to control its destiny. Alex once said, "The real guardians of progress are not the politicians at Westminster or even those in Holyrood, but the energised activism of tens of thousands of people who I predict will refuse to go meekly back into the political shadows. The people of Scotland will honour Alex Salmond's memory by carrying forward his vision as we continue to fight for a better Scotland with the confidence and the ambition to become a normal, independent nation. Let Alex Salmond be remembered as the First Minister who made the political weather, a leader who inspired ambition by building bridges, not walls. Scotland's greatest First Minister may now no longer be with us, but his spirit, his wisdom, and his legacy will guide us forward. Alex, like too many of those giants on whose shoulders we now stand, may not see the destination of their dream for Scotland. Yet one thing is clear, his place on Scotland's journey is indelibly forged through his determined work and unwavering passion to prevail.
Thank you. We will now move into a short period of suspension before we move to the rest of this afternoon's proceedings, which will resume around 3:05. Thank you.